In the mountains of southern Utah resides a giant said to be the largest living organism on the planet. But it doesn't live among the trees. It is the trees. It's called the Pando Forest. Yet its name, like its looks, is deceiving. Pando, Latin for eye spread, is in actuality a single aspen tree. A single gigantic aspen tree.
We have it mapped at 106 acres, and we estimate it roughly 80 million pounds. So it's a big organism.
It's the largest tree by weight, and it's the largest tree by landmass, bar none. No other tree can claim that it is both the largest tree by weight or landmass. There's nothing like it in the world.
Lance Odit has been researching the Pando tree and its deceptive nature for over a decade.
How does something have 47,000 tree trunks? And the point is that it's not really a tree trunk, it's all connected underground.
But how? To unlock the answer, we must examine the way Pando procreates.
Pando is an aspen clone, and what that means is that all of these individual branches that you're seeing here, they all come from the same DNA profile.
Unlike other trees, aspens can reproduce via sexual reproduction, in which pollination fertilizes the seed of a wholly new organism, as well as asexual reproduction, which produces a genetic clone. The first Pando tree sprouted from a single fertilized seed. That tree then sent out roots which produced suckers that grow into new trunks, each one a genetically identical clone of that original Pando tree. And due to Utah's ideal climate and soil conditions, Pando continues to spread to this day.
And that's all interconnected by this massive root system that some folks have suggested reasonably could span 12,000 miles if laid end to end.
That's enough to wrap around the Earth 1.5 times. And ensure a healthy ecosystem.
It's like a latticework, and that acts like an anchor that pulls the trees to the ground while they're blowing around in the wind.
The trees themselves can grow to 100 feet tall, making Pando a giant in height, as well as sprawl and weight.
The dry weight estimate is 13.2 million pounds. Aspen are water hungry trees, and so the reality is it's probably more like 70 or 80 million pounds at its prime each summer.
Pando is forever evolving. Individual aspens typically do not live beyond 130 years. When they die, their nutrients replenish the earth, helping each new clone that sprouts.
That branch is gonna fall off as it gets taller. And if you look around here, we got some pretty tall stems. So if another tree falls down, they can come in under that and shoot straight into the sky.
It's a cycle that has been going on for millennia, though determining Pando's actual age has proved to be elusive.
There's been a lot of debate about Pando's age. For a long time, people thought 80,000 years old. Simply impossible. This land that Pando calls home was covered in glaciers until about 12 or 13,000 years ago.
Counting the rings of a tree will only account for around 200 years.
Charcoal studies seem to indicate that you've had a stable aspen clone here for about 9,000 years.
As a healthy Pando continues to expand, experts believe it could live on for thousands of years.
We have this idea, because we've mapped this tree, that it's like this static thing, when the reality is that it's been changing shape and size and form as it's grown towards us in history.